Well, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Claude, as you know, and welcome to Bible study. I'm just going to take off the mask here, and we are socially distanced. Travis is the producer this afternoon, so we opened with a picture, a slide from our garden, and I just took that this morning. It was about, it was before 10 because I came over here, so it was like 9:30 or something. And you can see how the shadows are making their way across the slide. The zinnias are partially in sun and partially in the shade because things are changing in the fall. And the sun is rising later, setting earlier, and the morning shadows are really quite distinctive. So I thought I'd just open with that beautiful slide of our backyard. Now today is going to be different. Now we don't really work at this to be different from one week to the next, but this week is different because there's no guitar here. Yeah, there's no guitar. Well, what happened was, you see this hand here, and there's a bandage on this middle finger because I was doing some work around home with a utility knife, and I cut my finger rather deeply. In fact, I can feel it. So I cut it rather deeply, and it's bandaged up, so I can't bend it. So, like, I'm not playing the guitar this week. And I'm hopeful that by next week, we'll be back in good shape. And I'm going to have a surprise for you next week. I'm going to bring another musical instrument and maybe play something else. So that's something to look forward to. But today is going to be different, even odd, because for a long time now, I've been bringing a guitar to Bible study. Something else is different too. You notice I'm wearing a white pants again today. I'm not sure if this will be the last time, because white is a summer color, isn't it, for you who are women. I'm sure, like, when it comes to the fall, you put away things that are light and white. So this might be the last for the white pants, the black, and of course that short sleeve shirt. So we'll see what next week brings, but right now it's just gorgeous, isn't it? And the leaves around Grove Park Home, the trees are just beautiful. And we love those trees. They're just the most beautiful color. But on the other hand, I have some really good jokes. I have a report from the backyard and a couple of really exciting things to show you, surprise things. And then I have a couple of Shel Silverstein poems I want to read to you. I picked out a couple. And then I have also something special by way of music. Now, I can sing a cappella, Amazing Grace, and some of you will be able to sing with me. And then I'm going to invite you to go home with me, because I recorded a song in my office at home. And Travis is going to insert that into our video, our YouTube video. So there's going to be that. Oh, we have a prayer for the day too, I forgot about that. And then the lesson of the day is going to be about being grateful in retrospect. That is, when we look over the course of our lives, we can find many things for which we're grateful. And as we're just in the Thanksgiving season, and just last weekend was Thanksgiving weekend, we're still in that kind of mode of thought, aren't we? And so I want to talk about looking back at our lives and seeing the hand of God. That's it in a nutshell. And after that, I'll recite the Lord's Prayer together off a benediction. And then following that, Gail and I will do Go Now and Pass It On, our duet. Now, this will be a cappella on my part. So we're going to do the duet, and that will bring our Bible study to a close. So I was up on Spruce today at Bible study time, so I miss a lot of you. Like, it was good to see Isla and Eunice and Bev and Lorraine. And who else was there? Because I know you come faithfully at I really do miss seeing all of you together in the big room. But it's great to see you from week to week, wherever you are gathering at Grove Park Home. And I'm going to start doing that. Just pop in at Bible study time to Willow, Spruce, Pine, Aspen, Maple, and see all of you in person. And you'll notice that I look very much like the guy on the screen. So on the lighter side, the frustrated child said, "How soon will I be old enough to do as I please?" And his parent or her parent said, "I don't know. Nobody has ever lived that long." Like that. Never believe anybody who tries to prove something with statistics. 83.5% of them are completely made up. Yeah, that's pretty good. Teacher, can anyone tell me why the U.S. Capitol, the capital is the United States, Washington, has a rotunda? And the student says, "So politicians can run around in circles?" A rotunda? Not bad. And this one I like very much. If people are meant to fly, why are airports located so far from downtown? I'll say that oftentimes they're way, way out there, aren't they? Yeah. I was in Denver in November a couple of years ago, and the airport's like a half an hour by bus or train, I guess it was. It's a long ways away. And finally, a bit of wisdom, never test the depth of the water with both feet. Yeah. Have you done that before? Not good. So those are kind of my jokes for the day. And while we're in that sort of frame of mind, I picked out a couple of Shel Silverstein poems that I like. And coincidentally, they're on page 32 and page 64. So that's just a coincidence, it just struck me. Okay, first of all, this is entitled, oh no, it's 32, sorry. This is called Here Comes. And it's a good poem for this time of year. All right, it's called Here Comes, and there really isn't any line drawing with it, so I don't need to show you it particularly. So here's Here Comes by Shel Silverstein. Here comes summer, here comes summer, chirping robin, budding rose. Here comes summer, gentle showers, summer clothes. Here comes summer, whoosh, shiver, there it goes. That's our experience in Southern Ontario. And I think I told you about the four seasons that we have here. I'm going to keep this as one of my favorites because we have four seasons. Almost winter, winter, still winter, and road construction. I may have told you that last week. That's just on the top of my mind. Page 64. And this is called Snap. And it just shows a picture of an umbrella. So I don't really need to bring it close to you, but umbrella. Is this something that you think about? Because I read this and I thought, it's called Snap. She was opening up her umbrella. She thought it was going to rain. When we all heard a snap, like the clap of a trap, and we never have seen her again. So that's a poem called Snap. Okay, so that's Shel Silverstein. And we move on from my jokes to the report from the backyard. I have some exciting things to show you today. Now, fall is such an interesting time. Now, spring is an interesting time because we have lots and lots of migrating birds coming through Barrie, through our backyard, this whole area. And fall is such an interesting time because some of the birds that were here during the summer have gone, but others are coming. Now they're passing through. Some of them are passing through on their way to someplace warmer, but some of them come here and they stay. And I'm thinking particularly of the juncos, the little gray birds, slate colored with the white breast, because they have been here about a week. And they will stay all winter until in the spring. And when the juncos leave in the spring, then we know that the weather is turning to be warmer. And all the bugs and insects, like monarch butterflies, are leaving. Some of the dragonflies, because some dragonflies migrate, so they're leaving as well. And flowers, of course. My wife Elaine has been working in the yard all day, because the delphinium, which is a gift to us, had to be planted in the ground so it will survive. And a lot of other things have to be cleared away. There's really a lot of work in the backyard. Some of the ornamental stuff, we have like ladybugs on our lilac tree. They have to be taken down and taken in. And there's just a lot of work around a house in the fall. So it interests me a great deal to see the birds that are passing through. And in just a few minutes, I've got slides of two birds that have been around our backyard. And I'm going to tell you a bit about them before we see the slides, which I'll describe when we get to them. I have a nice photo of a pine warbler. Now, these pine warblers, they're not that uncommon, but we don't see them in Barrie in the summer, but we see them in the spring and in the fall, because they're going a bit further north to Muskoka perhaps in the spring, and they're coming back through in the fall. And they'll spend perhaps even as much as a few days here. So they just stop, get a cup of coffee, a snack, say hello to their friends if there are any traveling with them, and then they're on their way to someplace warmer. And you'll see these little birds, the pine warblers, you can see them down in the Caribbean islands, should you be traveling down there, which not too many people will be doing this winter because of the pandemic. And the second bird I want to show you is a woodpecker. And last week I showed you one of these yellow-bellied sapsuckers from a book, large book of birds. But this week I have some photos that I took myself. Now, we've been living in this neighborhood since 1989 when we got married. And we've never had one of these birds in our backyard. But as the word indicates, yellow-bellied sapsucker, they're birds that suck sap. And it's a woodpecker. So what it does is it makes holes in the bark of the tree so that the sap runs out. And it sucks up the sap. It drinks the sap out of the tree. Now, the sapsucker makes these holes, or not so little holes, some of them, around the tree. The sap runs out. And in the fall, when it's still warm, the sap, in fact, will run down the trunk of the tree. And the sapsucker drinks the sap. So it's called yellow belly. And if you see the bird up in the tree, you might not notice that it really does have something of a yellow belly. And I think probably we may have had both birds at the same time. So I'm going to back up now and talk a little bit about, point out to you, show you these slides of the pine warbler, which I've been talking about a little bit. And the photo, the first slide, I believe, is of the pine warbler perched on the handle of our wheelbarrow in our backyard. And it's just a beautiful little bird. Yellow with streaks on its chest, on its breast. And there are two or three slides of the warbler. And the last one, I think, third one maybe, is of the warbler up in the mountain ash tree with the woodpecker just looking ahead. And now I'm going to show you, Travis is going to bring up, I have two, three, four slides of the yellow-bellied sapsucker with it on the tree by itself. And, you know, it's making those little holes. And the first one, it doesn't appear to me to have any red on its head. And I'm not sure whether it's the female or whether it's a young one, but I think we had two. because the first slide doesn't really show you any red, but by the time we get to the second and third slide, you see very much a red head and red under the chin. Do birds have chins? I don't know if birds have chins. They have necks. So on the neck, let me say that. And that would be the male. And the mountain ash trees, the bark is fairly soft. And so the woodpecker was out there, and you couldn't hear it when it was tap, tap, tapping, making its hole, making holes around this tree. But I had seen it in the backyard, and it was too big for a downy woodpecker. And we have a pair of downies around all the time. So I thought maybe it was a hairy woodpecker. But then when I got the binoculars out and I looked in the bird book, this is a yellow-bellied sapsucker. And the last slide that I had is of this woodpecker sunning itself. And you can see the red under its, do birds have chins? Necks and beaks anyway. And you can see that its breast is clearly yellow. And so this is again in the mountain ash tree. And in the morning, by mid-morning, the sun shines into these trees and the birds in fact sit there and get warm because they're like you and me, they like to cozy up to the heater. So those are the slides that I wanted to show you of the pine warbler and of the yellow-bellied sapsucker. And the one slide there, the little warbler is right there with the woodpecker saying, you know, I can read its mind. I read bird brains. It's a little warbler saying, can I have a drink? So I don't know what sap would taste like out of a mountain ash tree. I mean, we take sap from maple trees, don't we? And we make sugar out of it and it's delicious. But these birds all liked the sap from the mountain ash tree too. Now, the woodpecker stayed about 10 days and now it's gone because I guess maybe it's got colder and the sap is not running the way it was before. And I guess in the fall, the sap goes down, doesn't it? It kind of drains out of the tree. Tree protects itself. And the sap goes down. Anyway, really, really interesting. So that's the report from the backyard. That's a special report with photos, some pretty good slides, which I took, or did Elaine take them? I think I took most of them, but Elaine has the good camera. So those are all taken with her Canon camera with a zoom lens. Now that brings us to our prayer for the day. Now, since the theme of my talk today is being grateful for God's hand through the course of our life, I think that we'll make that our topic. We're kind of leaning out of Thanksgiving weekend and staying on that particular theme. But I'm sure you have in your life, if you think back about the turns and twists in your life, you can see particular points along the way where it was clearly the hand of God, that something was going to happen, but it didn't. Something came your way when it shouldn't. Things worked out when it didn't look like they would. You know, you have to believe when these things happen because there's no proof. It's you thinking, wow, that was really something. So join me in prayer, would you please? Lord, we thank you for this day in the fall when all the beauty of fall is around us. We thank you for this time of the year when nature kind of just goes crazy in a great display. Thank you for everything that's happening around us and the message that it contains. Birds and insects and trees and everything around us is changing and leaning towards another season. And help us within ourselves see what's going on and lean in the same direction and accept and enjoy what is coming each day. And Lord, this day we're thanking you for being a part of our life. Since the time we were born. And we thank you, Lord, for accompanying us on our journey as an unseen friend. And we thank you, Father, for those times in our life when your hand was quite apparent, when we might have written something off simply as coincidence, But given some faith in you and in your activities in the world, we now recognize your hand. We thank you for our parents who were before us, our grandparents who were before us, who taught us and from whom we learned so much. And thank you, Father, for people who were part of our family, our own family, our spouses, our children, grandchildren, all of those people who are, whom you have given to us to be with on our journey. We thank you for our friends here at Grove Park Home, for our table mates, for those who take care of us in a variety of ways, who look after this place, and who are during this really difficult time protecting us from harm that comes with this virus that has been going all around the world. So Lord, we thank you for Jesus. Thank you that he came to this earth and lived and died here and died for, not for himself, but for the sins of the world, for his friends and for his enemies, for all of us. We offer our prayer in his name. Amen. Okay. Now, the songs. Now, I'm just going to, I think I'll sing with you Amazing Grace. I'll just sing it a cappella, and some of you, you know the words, and you can sing along. And so I'll just do the first verse, and then we'll, Thomas will insert the clip of the song that I recorded at home. So I'm taking you home to my office in just a minute. And oh, yes, as well. You'll notice over here to my left, there's a record album. And this is Joan, this is Joe Stafford. And she's one of my favorite singers. And she would have been possibly one of your favorite singers. Sang all kinds of secular songs and so on, but she also recorded an album, and it has a song on it that we use. It's called The Sweet By and By. And since we're doing things altogether different today, I used to bring the boombox before I started bringing my guitar. I don't know why I didn't bring my guitar earlier, but anyway. So maybe we can fit that in as well, and we'll just show you the album cover, and I've got all separated and ready to go. So I'll just start Amazing Grace, and then we'll have Take You to My Office. And when that's done, I will give us this other song. So we'll have two full songs, and then we'll end, as we always do, with the last verse of Amazing Grace. So it goes this way. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. Okay, I'll take you home to my office now.
Make me new. Lord Jesus, amen. For it seems that in so many ways I'm not enough like you. Take this weary vessel I am in, and lonely once again. Take my life, take my spirit, make me new. Have thine own way. Take this weary vessel, I am here. I am without complete. But that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou didst become me, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. Take me now, Lord Jesus, make me new. For it seems that in so many ways I'm not enough like you. Take this weary vessel I am in, mold me once again. Give my life to be spirit. Just a closer walk with me. Jesus is my creed. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Make me new, Lord Jesus, make me new. I'm not enough like you. Take this weary vessel I am in and hold me once again. Take my life, take my spirit, make me new.
So now I'm going to, I'm just going to reach over here. I'm going to bring the boombox. We don't rehearse these things, by the way. They just happen, okay? Now, if I can press the right, I think I'm going to press this. Yeah, and that should give us, I'm not sure about the volume.
We shall be on that little bit of
fall. There's a land that is there today.
Sing along if you like.
We will offer our tribute of praise for the glory.
off. I'll leave Jill Stafford's photo there. She had the most beautiful voice. She really, really did. She was a pop singer in front of a big band. I suppose in you would have heard her in the 1950s, into the 60s. Not sure when this album was recorded, but it's just, she has one of the world's most beautiful voices at the time. And that's a song we sing quite often, isn't it? So I like that album. So back to what's at hand. And today we're thinking about our lives and the course of our lives. And we're kind of remembering and giving thanks for the presence of God over a lifetime. And I'm not sure we can hear all those words as a title, God's presence in our lives. Maybe we'll give that the title. I'll just pass that on to our producer. God's presence in our life. God's presence in our lives. And if there's room for over a lifetime, that's good. And if there isn't, that's fine too. Now I want to read a passage to you from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 8. And Moses is preaching here. And God's people have come out of Egypt and they've come through the wilderness. They're going to enter the promised land. And he looks back at what God has done for them in the time of their escape and during this time in the wilderness. So I'll read this for you. This entire commandment that I command you today, Moses says, you must diligently observe so that you may live and increase and go in and occupy the land that the Lord promised on oath to your ancestors. Remember the long way that the Lord your God has led you these 40 years in the wilderness in order to humble you, testing you to know what was in your heart, whether or not you would keep his commandments. He humbled you by letting you hunger, then by feeding you with manna, with which neither you nor your ancestors were acquainted, in order to make you understand that one does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. The clothes on your back did not wear out, and your feet did not swell these 40 years. Know then in your heart that as a parent disciplines a child, so the Lord your God disciplines you. Therefore, keep the commandments of the Lord your God, by walking in his ways and by fearing him. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land with flowing streams, with springs and underground waters welling up in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land where you may eat bread without scarcity, where you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron and from whose hills you may mine copper. You shall eat your fill and bless the Lord your God for the good land that he has given you. May God bless the reading of his word. So here Moses is offering a retrospective. A retrospective. He says, you've come all this long way and God took care of you along the way. He says, like, your clothes didn't wear out, your shoes didn't wear out. God fed you in the wilderness and he's got more in store for you as well. One of the things that comes with growing old, older, is retrospection. When you get to be my age and your age, you can look back over decades and you can reflect on that. Now, I think one of the saddest parts of a life which was not long is that the person has not attained the age where such reflection is possible. Now, even my producer is just a young man, right? So he's got maybe a decade or two. He's growing into that period where you can do that kind of reflection, where you can become, go into retrospection. Do you know what I mean by that? Do you do that? And not all of us have the best memory anymore, but we do have some memory, or even a very precise memory, of what happened over the course of our lives. I was looking at the number of people here at Grow Park Home who are 100 years of age or more, at least four, and I think there are a number of people who are 99, and I'm thinking of, and people who still have very good memories. Imagine being able to reflect over such a long, long period of time. And one of the things that you do when you have those kinds of reflections, you wonder, what would have happened if I'd done this? Or what would have happened if I had done that? And what would have my life have been like if this had happened to me? It's about choices. We think, you know, it was really a wise choice to choose to do that. Perhaps it was a profession, perhaps it was moving someplace, you're thinking about the person that you married, and you think, wow, my life was so good. You know, we had a resident here one time who is Dr. Bernardo's Holmes boy, and he came from England. He was just a boy, and he was put on a farm someplace. Now, often these children were well taken care of, and we had residents who, we had four Dr. Bernardo's residents, and this man really had a hard time, and he was not treated well. And at Christmas time, the family would go and to the relatives for Christmas, and he'd be left alone on the farm. And he told me one time that he'd never received a Christmas present until he got married, and he received a Christmas present from his wife. And I'm thinking, there's a man who would have thought, you know, about his marriage and what a wonderful thing that was, and all that it brought into his life. So there are all kinds of things that we can reflect on that we couldn't when we were 15 years of age or 20 or even 30. And there's an insight that comes from that. And there are some things that have happened in my life where I've thought, you know, there was the hand of God for sure. And that's just a matter of faith, isn't it? That God was involved, that things could have happened very much differently than they did. And how about you? Can you think about, you know, turns in the road that you took, things that happened to you, that benefited you, that helped you grow, that helped you in your life? So I'm just asking you, I'm not asking for true confessions today, but just in those, for a few moments, if you can, take time to reflect on your life, your life as a whole, and maybe in its various decades, maybe in the things that happened to you, and to give thanks. Because that's really what Moses is calling for. He's preaching to these people who've been through a whole lot, and he says, here's how God was looking after you in different ways, and he's going to look after you in the future if you stick with him. So those are my brief thoughts today. I'm really calling on you to think as well. Now, as many of you know, my dad lived here too at Grow Park Home, and my dad came to live here because he had dementia. But you know, there were times when he was suffering from dementia, when he had really clear memories of when he was young. And in fact, he told me some things that I never knew before, of his youth, for example, and growing up on a farm north of Meaford out in St. Vincent Township. So perhaps there are things in your mind that come to you from time to time that lead you to say, wow, that was amazing. Now we're going to recite the Lord's Prayer together. I'm going to offer a benediction. And then, as usual, Gail and I are going to do our duet. It's going to be a cappella this week. I got to hear last week's on Spruce, or was it Willow, wherever it was. And it sounded pretty good. I really enjoyed that. And in fact, Gail and I sang together on Willow. So Let's recite the Lord's Prayer, offer the benediction, we'll sing the song, and then I'll say God bless you until we meet again. How's that? Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you. Okay. Are you ready? Many of you know this song anyway. May the Lord walk beside us as we leave this quiet place. For the Lord will always guide us if we walk in the light of his grace. May we feel God's love around us as he keeps us faithful and strong. For the peace of love surrounds us, and now we must pass it on. Go now and pass it on. Okay, thank you so much for being with us today. And may the Lord bless and keep you until we meet again.